The main difference of importing your media instead of linking to it is that you can use something called the Media Tool. Navigate to the Tools menu and choose Media Tool. The Avid will automatically scan for media for any attached drives, and it will display a list of projects from the media that it detects. What you may find interesting is even if the original projects have been deleted, the Media Tool may still show projects listed here. That's because it is detecting media that originally belonged to a project. It can do this because there is information that is embedded into each file when you import media into Avid. The next step is to select a list of drives for the media you would like to find. Click on the All Drives button to search across all your drives. At the bottom of the Media Tool, you will see three options for displaying media that belongs to a particular project. Within the Media Tool, the term Master Clip refers to all the pieces parts of a file. So, if I click on the Extreme Sports project and select Master Clips, you will see a list of master clips that belongs to this project. The term Precomputes refers to render files. In this example, these are render files for the Extreme Sports project. So, if you are going to completely clear up media for a project, make sure you select master clips and the Precomputes. The last option refers to the MXF media inside the Avid Media Files folder on your hard drive. Here's what the raw MXF media files look like. Now, I'm going to close the Media Tool and reopen it so I can also check master clips. If a master clip contains both video and audio elements, it's represented as one clip icon. So, here's my point. I'm going to select a clip within the Media Tool and then navigate to the Bin menu. Then I'll choose Select Media Relatives. So now you can see that this master clip points to these two raw media files. In most circumstances, there's no need to display the raw MXF media files, since a master clip refers to the individual pieces. With all this being said, if you're going to delete all the media from a specific project, selecting either of these two combinations, along with the precomputes, would accomplish the same result. To demonstrate, I'll select the master clips along with the precomputes for the Extreme Sports project. The next step is to select the master clips and/or precomputes that you would like to delete. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Command-A to select all the clips. Then, press the Delete key on your keyboard. Now, be careful when working with the Media Tool because deleting master clips will delete their associated media, which means any clips and bins that point to that media will become offline. The Media Tool is also a handy way of borrowing media from one project to another. So, for example, I'm inside a project called Charity Boxing Event. I can use the Media Tool to access content from another project called Miscellaneous Media. Inside, I have a clip of water and fire. You could simply drag the clip from the Media Tool into any bin. What's fantastic is the Avid knows that the media doesn't belong to your current project, but you are free to use it. So, without going into extreme detail, you can see how this can be a good strategy for keeping things organized. This is because the Media Tool reads the metadata of the MXF file structure and allows you to see which files belong to which project. Okay, now you have the basics of using the Media Tool.